Piotr Kobylański, Kobe Gym, Gdynia.
And, you know, the big difference, as I said, between these two guys, Buliet is 19 years old, Kobylański at 31. Kobylański's had over 150 fights himself and is an incredible amateur fighter. But at 31 years old, he's much, much older than his opponent, who's just 19. Physically, they're just about the same as far as height and weight is concerned, but the representative of the Kobe Gym in Gdynia, which is just a hop, skip, and a jump away from Gdańsk here, gonna have a lot of crowd support. We've seen him before on Fightbox for Makovsky Fighting Championship, and did a really good job there. He's fought before in K1 tournaments, and has fought before in King of Kings as well, back in 2010, and has also fought for the Beast of the East, and also a lot of good European championships and whatnot, so expect good things from Kobylański as well.
Dzisiaj w narożniku holenderskim nie ma postaci Mike'a Paseniera. On jest razem z Badrem Ali.
Take a look at the eyes of Ilias Buliet. Boy, is he ready for this one.
Piotr Kobylański, również jedna z wyróżniających się postaci polskiego rynku.
I don't know, I kind of caught something in the eye of Kobylański. Maybe got some butterflies in his stomach. I don't know if he's intimidated or nervous, or maybe just doesn't seem to be as focused and deterred. Look at Buliet just staring a hole through him. I might be a little bit intimidated too if I had Buliet staring at me like that in the ring. Of course, it's very obvious how important it is to be mentally prepared for a fight. It's just, if not more, important to be mentally prepared as it is to be physically prepared. Ilias Buliet coming out here early on, putting the pressure on Kobylański. Kobylański slipping there momentarily, took his eyes off the ball for just a second, and Buliet going right back to work on him. Good combinations by the Pole. Buliet firing right back with a nasty uppercut that time. Was Ilias Buliet. Well, he really came here to win today, didn't he? Buliet really putting the pressure on Kobylański here. Kobylański again, just like Butkiewicz, really has a chance to shine on a global level. Nice head kick by Buliet. He looks like he's got a little bit of a, I don't know if it's blood, could be, coming from the right corner, under the right eye. Look at that, double jab, doubling up on the jab. One upstairs, one downstairs. Big knee again. Kobylański's in trouble. He is really being overwhelmed here, halfway through round number one. Buliet almost just having his way with him. It's almost like he's not even firing back. He's not even doing anything offensively. Is Kobylański. I'm not sure this one's going to make it to the final bell, ladies and gentlemen. It might not even make it out of round one. Kobylański finally starting to fire back here. He's got to turn it up offensively a little bit if he wants to survive. Kobylański now starting to be a little bit more active in there. He's at about a 3 or a 4 right now. He needs to turn that aggression up to about an 8 or a 9 if he even wants to hang with Buliet in this fight. Bouliad just oozing machismo, so confident in there. If he got rocked a couple times with some punches, that might make him think twice, might make him question himself a little bit. That's what Kobylański needs to do. Give him something to think about. Coming up on the end of this first round here, Bouliad was very aggressive in the opening of round number one and started to slow down about halfway through, and then right at the end has another solid flurry of offense. Obviously some damage to the right eye of Kobylański. Bouliad very aggressive in the opening. I think it was that uppercut that may have opened him up, or maybe a knee. He landed a couple of solid knees in there too. Either way you look at it, that was a solid opening round for Ilias Bouliad. And Kobylański's got his work cut out for him here at King of Kings from Gdańsk, Poland.
Grat uderzeń, większość celu. Piotr dobrze blokował gardą, ale w pewnym momencie...
Looks like that cut is right between the eyes. The upper inside corner of the right eye, and Bouliad goes right to work on Kobylański. Oh, Kobylański nailed him! Is he going to get an eight count? Oh, that was a solid shot by Piotr Kobylański. And Bouliad now still not backing down. Kobylański is just getting warmed up here. This kid just might be a slow starter today. Well, we don't want to put it off for too much longer. Bouliad better be careful of those headbutts. He's really getting close with his head. Look at that. He's leaning right in with his head. That's illegal. You think he's trying to open up that cut again? Ooh, that knee found its way through. Bouliad maybe trying to rough him up a little bit. Look at those headbutts. Come on, ref, give me a break. You can't lead in with your head like that. I don't know any sport where you can headbutt somebody legally.
Kobylański zrobił to jednak lepiej, tak? Teraz pracuje.
Maybe out in the schoolyard. That's about it. Bouliad is really being aggressive here. Solid low kick that time by Kobylański in return. He's still got a little something left. There's another low kick. Bouliad is just, wow, look at the snap. Look at the snap and the power that he has in that low kick.
Ale tu nerwy nic nie pomogą. Piotrek jest cierpliwy.
Kobylański now going back to work. All that punishment that he's taken, and he's still able to fight like this, is really saying something about Kobylański. There's another solid knee. Kobylański's really got to be weary of those knees from Bouliad. Looks like Bouliad is even limping a little bit in there from those low kicks. Kobylański needs to go back to work with those. Kobylański has much more powerful, muscular legs than Bouliad does. Bouliad kind of long and lanky. Kobylański looks to be a little bit more solid, more physically powerful in there.
One są coraz mniej dokładne. Piotrek musi uważać.
30 seconds now. Round number two. Kobylański still looking good, looking much better than he did in round number one. But I'm not so sure that he's winning this round. Oh, beautiful knee. The blood starts to pour from the center of the face of Kobylański. Oh, and a solid right hand. I think he may have busted his nose. He may have broken his nose with that knee. Oh, that is gruesome. Oh boy. Looks like his nose just exploded there. No doubt from one of those knees. Bouliad landed four or five at least really solid knees that looks like it just broke the nose of Kobylanski. Got the cut man over there in the corner looking at him. Doesn't look physically like he's taken too much damage. Taking a lot of shots to the head, but not so many in the nose and the face or anything like that. I think the most effective weapon so far that Kobylanski has been able to get going have been his low kicks. Oh, that is gruesome.
To nie jest nic groźnego, aby nie przeszkadzało w oddychaniu.
I tell you what, there's a lot of blood coming from the face of Kobylanski. And Buliaid not wasting any time here. He's trying to finish him off. If he takes any more damage to the nose or to the face, it's not going to be good for him. Kobylanski needs to focus on the low kicks, I think. Focus on his boxing. There's that low kick. Make him pay. Look at the speed. Well, I'll tell you what, this Buliaid kid is fast. Fast as lightning. He keeps leaning in with that headbutt, too. Give me a break. Referee really needs to consider what those headbutts are doing. That is not legal in any way, shape, or form. Look at the nose of Kobylanski. Really in bad shape here. Buliaid nailed him with a left hook that time, right on the ear. There's that knee again. There it is again! Kobylanski getting rocked with those knees, but still forging forward. Look at that kick. Oh, he's just showing off now. Buliaid just on a different level in this fight. Look at all those shots. Kobylanski's got a good defense, though. He's got his guard up nice and tight. A lot of those shots by Buliaid are not finding their way through, but the knees are. The knees are finding their way through each and every time. And Kobylanski's really got to be more conscious of that. This third round is, again, belongs to Buliaid. But if Kobylanski can make it to the bell, I think that's going to be a moral victory for him. He's got to avoid the knees, though. The knees are just brutal. Kobylanski now up against the ropes. He's got to move around in there a little more. Oh, beautiful shot. He may have actually got away with an elbow there. There's that knee. Look at the blood on the knee of Buliaid. That's not his blood. That's his opponent's blood. And you can tell those knees are connecting because he's got the blood all over his own knee. Buliaid's going to pay a visit to the emergency room, I have a feeling, after this fight. Oh, beautiful. That's the low kick that has really been effective in this fight. If he could just focus on that low kick, there it is again. Look at Buliaid, showboating in there a little bit, but he can afford to. Wow, look at that. He hasn't slowed down at all. If anything, he's gotten quicker since the first round. Closing seconds, and it's over. Wow, what a fight, ladies and gentlemen. That is what King of Kings is all about. What action. You wonder why King of Kings is one of the top kickboxing promotions in the whole world. You're seeing exactly why. Ilias Buliaid of the Netherlands, Mike's gym, one of the top gyms in the world. Fighters like Gokhan Saki, Badahari, and this young man, Ilias Buliaid, who, wow, looking very, very impressive. And the fact that Piotr Kobylanski was able to hang in there after he got his nose busted and after he took that kind of a beating, it really says a lot to him, too. He's a really tough guy, really gave it all he could, but I don't see how you can score this fight any other way. It's basically a landslide for the fighter from the Netherlands.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now. Mamy decyzję. In the blue corner.
Decyzja.
Well, no surprise there. As the 19-year-old, Ilias Bouliaid, who's actually, he's scheduled for a fight in November in Japan for the K-1 World Championship in a reserve fight in that tournament. So he looks like he's really got himself a bright future in this sport. Koblanski at 31 years old is obviously in his prime, maybe winding down a little bit, but obviously he's got a lot of good fights left in his tank as well, and really proved himself here as a tough fighter. But Ilias Bouliaid, just a little bit better. Koblanski, though, definitely showing what Polish fighters are made of, but there's just something about Bouliaid, wow. I think it's just the fact that he trains at Mike's gym, and not only that, he's obviously just a super talented athlete.